Hello again, guys. I've been taking a trip down a YouTube rabbit hole that has led me back to the 90s and the 2000s and what's possibly the greatest music app ever created. Yes, it's Winamp. And to a somewhat lesser extent, if you are a Linux user, Audacious, and its grandfather, XMS. Just a few days ago, there was an announcement from Winamp that they will be opening up their source code. This is a big deal for oldies like me. This really got my nostalgia juices flowing. Now, if you were a teenager in the late 90s and you were listening to music, it was probably on MP3s, and it was probably using Winamp. On Linux, there was XMS, which was pretty much the same application redone by open source devs. Now, if you've used either of these apps, you know the killer feature was the skins. Don't get me started on all the ladies I pulled purely based on my Winamp skin collection. So, without further ado, let's get skinning. So the Winamp Skin Museum has a bloody gigantic collection. It might even be every skin ever. I'll add the link in the description. Of course, it has the OG Winamp skin. Lots of others, which are basically images of movies, anime, games, or just ladies. It's amazing the level of detail put into some of these skins. I might use the search to find a few that I remember by name. Just trying to get the old rusty brain working. I think the name was Leet. Wow, it's here. I might actually open up a couple of old screenshots later on, just for comparison. Okay, so I downloaded a few I like. Now you get them in WSZ format, and you will need to rename them to .zip files. And after that, you will need to copy the archives into the Audacious Skins folder. That's in User Share Audacious. Skins, if you're using Fedora, check the location for your own distro. You will also need to use sudo to copy them in. I'll just fast forward this so you don't need to see my slow typing. Okay, so provided you've done everything right, the skin should just show in the list under settings. Wow, this really brings back some memories. Winamp was one of the first tools to allow skinning like this. Even games didn't have character skins back then. It was really cutting edge stuff. I also really miss just having the equalizer just right there. This is the one I really wanted to see because of what I'm about to open up. So this is a screenshot of my desktop from 2002, so more than 22 years ago. I used this skin with XMS. It's wild to think about how much music and how we consume music has changed. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. There's really only one MP3 I can play to end this video. Until next time.
Winamp. It really whips the llama's ass.